go on.
Yeah, whatever.
Second date update.
That guy's a cheater.
I'm just manifesting.
Ooh, it's Confession Wednesday.
Tell us your secrets.
It's the Jon and Chantel Radio Podcast.
It's a podcast?
It's a podcast.
Oh.
Jon and Chantel's Radio Podcast.
It is Tuesday. Good morning. It's Jon and Chantel. Well, I've been waiting. I've been on the edge of my seat since yesterday's show.
Oh.
Did you stay off social media from 6 to 8 last night?
I did.
Did you?
Oh, yeah. During the show, I set one of those...
Like a reminder?
Sleep timers.
Oh, yeah.
That everybody, it's like, this person has their notification silenced and it's so annoying. I was like, I'm going to do that too.
Yeah.
So I had silenced everything from 6 to 8.
How'd it feel? Did you notice it?
I noticed it.
Did you?
I feel like I had a little shake.
Yeah.
But I did it day one.
I'm proud of you. There it is.
Thank you. Thank you.
Setting those goals and hitting them. Speaking of yesterday's show, we got a text from yesterday's podcast saying you were talking about how to wear a shirt. Don't say button so many times. I have button phobia. Go ahead. Look it up. I'm not kidding. So what? I looked it up. Its official name is compunophobia. Nailed it.
Wow.
With a K, in case you were wondering.
We share the big news around here.
It's the fear of buttons. It affects 1 in 75,000 people. Isn't that fun to know we have one of those listeners on our show?
Yes.
I know. I thought
How
that was
special.
Cool. Would you consider yourself a true crime fan?
Yeah. I mean, not...
Like, do you listen to the true crime podcast
No.
and, you know, live that kind of life?
If somebody starts telling me a story about it, I'm, like, interested.
So you're into it to a certain level, but...
I'm not going to go search it out myself.
Okay, got it. Well, then this job is not for you. But if anyone else listening has ever wanted to be a detective but not a cop, now's your chance because the Tucson Police Department, they have created a new position that's exactly like that. It's called a professional staff investigator. You basically get to be a detective without the requirement of the 3 years of a cop first.
Uh-huh.
Here's the department talking about it.
You know, there's been different things in the media where community members help solve cases. So we want to get those people. We want to get that untapped potential. Once this is all done, they're going to go through a 7-week academy. Then they're going to go through 12 weeks of field training. And then once they're done, their day's going to look very similar to our other detectives. They'll be able to go to any scene once the scene is safe. So they won't be first responders. They won't have a gun. If they interview a suspect, that person will have to be made completely safe and they'll have a sworn officer with them.
So it does require some training, as you heard. 7 weeks of police academy, 3 months of field training. They do say you need at least an associate's degree. But the examples that they're talking about are loss prevention, public safety, crime scene management, forensics. You get to visit crime scenes, collect evidence, interview suspects, bust bad guys.
Wow.
No gun, though.
Yeah.
And it's paying not bad, $22 to $33 an hour. And they're hiring 20 of these people.
That's a lot. Telling,
there are people who are into, like, you know, true crime. Who are like, I could be a good detective. But they don't want to be, like, the police officer part of it. We're going to jump on this opportunity.
Yeah, I mean.
It's not you. You
it's
are not
me.
You are not excited about this.
This is not me.
No.
But I do know people that would be, like, all over this.
Oh, yeah. I watch those unsolved mysteries. Guess what? I solve them.
Sure you do.
Mm-hmm. I'm like,
I'm sure
figured
you
out
do.
It was the girlfriend. It's always the girlfriend. All right, we'll do a quote. We'll kick off the show. Don't wait for extraordinary opportunities. Seize common occasions and make them great.
Yeah.
You can turn anything into a great day.
Yes, you can.
And it starts today.
Starts today and it starts with you. Let's do it. Let's talk what's trending. There is a real life Malibu Barbie dream house in Malibu, California.
Did you see it?
Have you seen the photos?
Yeah, yesterday
amazing.
They had a Twitter launch with it. I do not like how they launched it, though.
Why?
They launched it as all these like local journalists are like, I was just flying over the hills and where did this come from? It's like, I'm sure it's...
Like, it's been being built for
right, because it's this massive mansion that's pink and they have a slide.
It literally looks like the Barbie... Is this CGI? Is this fake?
No, it looks amazing.
It looks amazing. So anyway, the real-life Barbie Dreamhouse, Ken, is hosting two free one-night stays for two guests, okay? at the bright pink three-story house. Guests will also get their own yellow and pink Impala skates and a surfboard beginning July 31st.
Sounds fun. Like, what a great idea.
It sounds so fun. All the press they're doing for Barbie Dreamhouse.
Let me ask you this,
or for Barbie movie.
Are you beginning to worry? There's so much good press. There's so, like, even, like, the artists are doing their stuff. Like, you have the new Nicki Minaj Barbie World song, and you have, like, the Dua Lipa song, and is there too much press? Like, does that mean no.
It's Barbie.
Okay, so it's going to be
good. They're
not
messing this up.
Okay.
The listing goes up on July 17th at 10 a.m. Can you book it without getting the free thing? Like, could I pay to book it? That's the only thing I couldn't understand.
I assume yes. I thought you just had to win it. I didn't think it was one of those things you could just
why
book.
Would they build this Barbie Dreamhouse for only a two-nights thing and then never again?
Be done? What are they charging for it?
It doesn't say yet because it's not listed.
It's a mansion.
Until the 17th.
Okay.
I know, I'll have to stay...
put on a
keep
calendar.
Keep our finger on the pulse with that one. A woman threw her mom's ashes on stage during a Pink show in London. Here's kind of how it went down.
You'll hear Pink respond to it, and then you'll hear... She kind of puts him down next to the speaker, doesn't know what to do, and then continues with the concert. So here you go.
This is your mom? I don't know how to feel about this.
Like, she literally, like, grabs the urn.
She grabs the ashes.
The ashes.
And she, like, I don't know how to feel about this. She puts them down. How do you respond? What do you do as Pink? Like, you're like,
you just handed
thanks?
Me your mother's ashes.
And then after the show, like, what are you supposed to do with them? I'm not...
At
me,
least, here's the thing.
Yeah.
Could have been worse. She could have tossed him at Pink.
That's true. Just, one of those kind of things.
Right.
I just feel... Like, what do you expect Pink to do afterwards? How selfish are
you?
Yeah,
what was she... And it's in the middle of the song, so it's like, was she supposed to stop the song and talk about it?
Yeah. And then afterwards, what does Pink do? Does Pink now have to bury him? Is she supposed to carry him around?
I don't think it was a gift. I don't think she gifted the mom. I think that she just wanted the mom to be on stage with Pink. Maybe it was only for one song.
I need to know the backstory, because what if the mom was a huge Pink fan and wanted to be up on stage with Pink, and there she got her chance? Like, I need to know more.
If I was Pink,
yes,
I would be going, where was security in this? Because there's a huge barrier between the stage and the crowd. There's like 4 feet. You know what I'm saying?
But I wonder, I didn't see the beginning of it. You know how sometimes they grab stuff and they sign? And like, was it one of those moments?
Right. But security, where's security? Why didn't you not stop this woman from putting ashes up in my face?
Tacky or no?
I would say tacky.
What about throwing undies? Tacky or no?
Yes, tacky. Well...
Throwing a cell phone. Hit BB Rex in the head.
Absolutely tacky. You should go to jail.
So we shouldn't throw anything up on the stage?
No, you should just put your hand out and like...
Wait for someone to touch your hand, right?
Yeah.
That's
Ooh.
It. Yeah.
Okay, something super exciting. The United States Air Force is going to be sending crews into the air Tuesday all over the country. Including here in Utah to celebrate 100 years of aerial refueling.
Woo!
The Utah Air National Guard 151st Air Refueling Wing is going to fly over the state today in honor of this achievement. So, here's the deal.
Yes.
If you want to catch this flyover, there is a map that we're going to put up on our Instagram page at Mix 105 in Utah that shows their course.
Mm-hmm.
But it's going to start at 9:40 at Utah State University. By 9:50, they're going to be at Lagoon.
Dang.
By 9:56, it'll be the state capital Air Guard and Reserve display. They're going to be doing those things at the Capitol.
Okay.
At 9:56 and 10:15, so they're going to be redoing the Air Guard and Reserve displays.
Yeah.
By 10:03. They're going to be at Brigham Young University.
Oh, my gosh.
They're going to be at BYU.
They're flying
so
by.
So, basically, between 9:50 at Lagoon,
mm-hmm.
and then you've got 10 minutes that they're going to get to Utah, BYU, and UVU.
Okay.
Okay? So, if you live anywhere along I-15 in that general area, just you're going to hear it.
Oh, yeah.
So, you want to make sure you get outside so you can see it. I texted my nanny, and I was like, hey, make sure my kids are outside between 9:45 and 10:05.
Yeah.
So that they can see this. And then it's going to head all the way down to like Cedar City and St. George, turn around, come back, head up to Heber and Park City.
It's awesome.
By, I love it's going like to be like down in St. George by 11, so it'll be back up, you know, by noonish to Heber and Park City.
2-hour round trip around the state.
So cool.
Yeah, that is cool. Epic. We had a hot topic. I'll be completely honest with you. We had something else.
This and is too good.
Chantel shared this story during What's Trending, and I'm like, we got to talk about it. So if you missed Trending, during a concert with Pink, Pink's singing, she's up on stage. At one point, a fan hands her a Ziploc bag.
No, throws a Ziploc bag on stage.
Like a legit Ziploc bag, as if she's going to lunch.
Yes, like it's leftover powdered sugar.
And inside the Ziploc bag were her mother's ashes.
So the ashes get thrown on the stage. Yep. Pink drops down, picks them up, holds them up in complete confusion and disgust.
Yeah.
And says, "Is this your mom?" And then, assuming the woman says yes, she goes, "I don't know what to do with this." And she drops the baggie back down, like in front of the speakers, kind of like hides it away, and like brushes her hands off while trying not to vomit.
Yeah.
Like, she's disgusted.
So, here's the audio. You'll hear her stop singing, ask, and then try to start back up doing her show, knowing she was just holding someone's ashes in a Ziploc bag.
I assume as soon as that song ended, she went and, like, washed her hands.
Is this your mom? I don't know how to feel about this.
I tell you, her voice is like shaky. She doesn't know what to do. Like she's a changed person once that happens.
Yeah.
It's tacky, right?
Tacky.
It's not fair to put Pink in that situation. No. That's how I feel about it.
It's not fair. If you want to do something like that, bring a beautiful urn. That's what it's called, right?
Yeah.
Some sort of capsule.
Mm-hmm.
During a meet and greet.
To hold and then take a photo.
To hold and take a photo.
But you're not handing it to.
That's what I'm saying. If you want to do something like that. If it was your mother's dying wish, you get approval, you bring it, and it, whatever. But you don't just launch it in a Ziploc baggie at someone.
Carried mom in your pocket all the way through security.
It's like warm.
Got to your spot. Good thing it didn't open.
I'm saying.
Poof. So here's our question. The video is on Instagram, right?
Yeah, I put it up on our Instagram page.
Okay, so you can actually see it happen at Mix 105.1 Utah. Pink's response and everything. And then our question to you is it tacky to throw ashes up on the stage?
Or are we just being ridiculous?
Are we prudes? Is it us? Are we not cool enough?
I think it's rude.
I don't think
it's a matter of tacky or not. I think it's rude.
I think it's tacky. You have no right to do that.
Right.
Yeah. And I just feel like that's something you want to warn someone about.
Right.
Like, you know, at Disney, we train... During normal orientation, they train you about dealing with people pouring ashes out of Disneyland.
Right.
But at least you're kind of ready for it always.
What is the protocol there?
You stop them.
Oh, you do?
Yeah, at least I don't know what it is now. Yeah.
Wow.
Oh, yeah. There's a whole thing about it. All right, go to Instagram. We want to get your votes at Mix 105.1 Utah. Up next, what's the last thing that made you cry? What's the last thing that made you cry? 844-649-1051. The kids have been mocking me. You know, I told you I took them to see Elemental. Wasn't a great movie. But anytime there's like a father and daughter moment.
Oh, getcha.
I bawl like a baby.
Okay.
I cannot help it. And there's a moment in Elemental towards the end between the father and daughter. And I got emotional.
Okay.
And it... Of course, because the kids know me, and they know how I get.
Uh-huh.
And I can feel my peripheral, and I'm in the middle, both of them turning their heads towards me.
Like, oh, dad's going to start crying.
And here I am, just like tears streaming down my cheek as I'm watching this dad and this daughter moment.
Uh-huh.
Sorry for having a heart, kids.
Yeah.
Sorry for loving you.
So funny.
And they've been ever since. They're like, oh, are you going to cry?
You're
going to cry? And they try to like recreate the scene between the two of them. And they're like, oh, is this going to make you cry? Right now?
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, they're bullies.
They are bullies.
I know. So yeah, that was the last time I cried on. It was Friday when I took them to. Friday afternoon was the last time I cried.
The last time I cried was Sunday night.
The airplane?
When I almost missed my airplane.
If you miss Chantel's airplane story, go back to yesterday's podcast.
Oh my gosh. It wasn't my fault.
Just search for John and Chantel in any podcast directory. Yeah, because you said you were like crying in once you finally got on the plane, and like the woman next to you was like,
the woman next to me is like,
made it.
She's like, hey, it's going to be okay. You made the flight. And I'm like, it's not about the flight. I'm like crying.
What about you? What was the last thing that made you cry? Was it a year ago? Was it a day ago? Was it this morning? I admitted something to you. I said that I cried on Friday. The movie Elemental did it to me. Father-daughter moment gets me every time. That's why I cry every time in Armageddon.
Oh my gosh.
This text says, I was staring at my kids last night, and I realized that they were growing older, and I didn't have much time with them. Started crying at the dinner table.
Oh my gosh.
Mom! Mom, what are you doing?
Why are you crying?
Why are you crying,
Mom?
Right now? It's been over 3 years since I've cried. I can't even remember the last time.
All right. Lies.
Good on you.
Okay, maybe you're not lying, but that's just crazy. I cry, honestly, every day. It's shocking. I haven't cried since Sunday.
My allergies have been making my eyes water heavily all morning. Does that count? No, that doesn't count. Went to a funeral for a family member over the weekend. That did it. Oh, yeah. Absolutely. What about you? Last thing that made you cry. Was it like me? Was it like a movie or a TV show? Was it a commercial, a YouTube ad?
Oh, yeah. Like the puppy dog video.
The puppy dog video. Call us, text us, join the show right now. What's the last thing that made you cry? I saw Elemental. Father and daughter moment. Yes, I cried. My kids are mocking me for it. Our buddy Derek, what up, Derek? Says, last time I cried was Sunday night as I held my 3-year-old daughter singing I Am a Child of God to her before bedtime.
Aww.
I haven't cried since a funeral last year, but that got me being a girl dad of two. Yeah, I get it.
That is so cute.
It gets you.
So funny. My kids busted out in a primary song yesterday.
Oh, did they?
Yeah, one of the rules, we have house rules.
Yeah, yeah.
And one of them is love one another.
Yeah.
And I was like, and number 7. Love one another. And they're like, start singing the song. And I'm like, okay.
Genevieve, morning, Genevieve. I'm not lying when I tell you that it's been 4 years since I've cried. I got divorced, cried for an entire year. I think I cried myself all out.
I get that.
Nothing left.
You have no more feelings.
Mm-hmm. I cried last night watching Instagram reels of homeless dogs stuck in kennels. Wait a minute, is this the same person who texted yesterday saying they get that on their feed all the time?
It's too much.
Lauren, morning Lauren. I had a good cry last night reading this book. There's nothing like a good cry. Are you that way? Do you like watching like those movies that will make you cry? Like, oh, that was a good cry. I got it out.
For me,
yeah.
If I am in an emotional state and I can't get myself to cry, mm-hmm, and get it out, like I have to physically get it out, I will turn on a sad movie just so I can cry.
Okay, so it's almost like therapeutic for you.
Yeah.
On Tuesday, my boyfriend was able to see his little daughter again after almost 3 years. Super emotional all week.
Wow, yeah. That's cool.
Watched Tarzan again after 10 years. Being a parent now, Kerchak's death hit me hard.
Oh, yeah.
Go to our Instagram page. Go to our Insta story. It's at Mix1051 Utah. And you need to check out the video from last night. Pink's doing a concert, and a person throws up onto the stage a Ziploc bag full of what, Chantel?
Ashes. Like her mother's ashes.
Her mother's ashes. Here's Pink realizing what she's holding and doesn't know what to do with it.
Many things. She could have been like, did you throw anthrax at me?
Right.
Like,
just a bag.
What is in here? This white powdery substance.
She's like, I don't know what to do with this. She kind of places it down, brushes off her hands,
like in disgust,
and tries to continue with the concert. It's a visual thing. You got to watch it. But then our question for our hot topic today is tacky or not for doing what that person did.
Tacky.
So I'm curious, as we go to our hot topic poll on Instagram on the Insta story.
Yep.
At Mix 105.1 Utah. It's 100% right? I assume it has to
you
be.
You would be shocked, John.
Really?
It is not 100%.
What is it?
It is 91% yes, tacky. 9% of people say no.
You're telling me that more people all agreed on grilling hot dogs over boiling than they do on throwing ashes up on stage?
Yeah.
I just want to make sure I understand.
Oh, yeah.
This is ridiculous. All right.
Think back to, like, last August.
Okay.
Starbucks brought back the pumpkin spice latte.
Yeah.
About 2 months too early. And everyone's mocking the pumpkin spice latte.
Mm-hmm.
And then they hopped in their cars and drove to Starbucks to get one.
Yeah.
So it's like, on social media, there's controversial things that people pretend that they hate, but really they love them.
Yeah. It's like, oh, they've become too popular, so then you gotta be like, oh,
it's like,
I don't like it.
Oh. Mm. Like drama. We all like drama. Mm.
What I like to do is act like I'm not into it, and then I sit here, and I let Chantel just tell me all the drama.
Yeah, and he loves it.
So then I can be a part of like what's going on in the world without acting like I'm too into it. You know, I'm playing it cool.
Air fryers.
I love air fryers.
I've actually not heard anyone say they don't like an air fryer.
The air fryer is the greatest invention
It really has been one of the. It has been one of the best appliance inventions since the Instapot.
It's, oh yeah, I'll use an air fryer 10 times to an Instapot.
Instapot, right? Mm-hmm. Pineapple on pizza, it is good.
Thank
Stop
you.
Saying that it's not good.
What's why Ew, do people complain
pineapple.
About it? Because it became cool to say you don't like pineapple on pizza.
Yes, so dumb. Apple and Google.
Oh.
Well, Apple's obviously the superior.
What? I don't understand. Like, people
like,
hate. Oh, like you have to choose a
you
side.
You have to choose a side.
You either have an Apple phone or you have like a.
Yeah, and it's like, ew, Apple. And it's like, okay.
I want whatever's going to be the cheapest.
I want the one that takes the best pictures. And we all know that it's Apple. Mm. And I don't care how many pixels your Pixel Google phone has. Whenever you transfer that photo out of the phone, it does not have the same quality. So everybody needs to just stop it.
Listen, it's just easier for me. With Apple to use the photo
the,
drop.
The Google or the group messages are easier. The airdropping is easier.
Yeah.
Everything is better with Apple. American versions of international cuisines. So it's like, oh, Taco Bell?
Oh,
really?
Stop it. Get out. Oh, this is your favorite kind of pizza? I had it actually in Italy.
You like Papa John's?
When I was in
pizza
Barcelona.
Hut?
Had the best sandwich of my life. Okay.
Like Chinese food. It's like, I love Panda.
Mm-hmm.
Get out of here. If you think that it's not authentic enough.
Look.
Bye.
I can get myself a croissant from Burger King just as good as somewhere in Paris.
The use of emojis. Yeah, people are like, oh, it's so lame to use emojis. Emojis are great.
Oops.
And I use them all the time.
Same.
So if you don't like emojis, probably never, ever, ever text me.
I'm still using the GIFs, so.
Right?
I use them all the time.
Oh, I love using GIFs.
Put up, blocked again. Let Jon and Chantel help with their 7:30 second date update.
I'm gonna say good morning to Rachel from Holiday. Hi, Rachel.
Oh, good morning.
Good morning. So tell us what's happening with Ben.
I have no idea.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
I wish I knew.
Yeah.
Like, I finally met someone like who loves what I love to do. I'm a golfer.
Mm-hmm.
And he is too. And so, he planned it and we went to golf round and we just had such a good time. Like, we were driving balls and like talking and.
Like so many guys would kill for a girl who's into golf.
Yeah, who wants to go to the
like,
driving range.
That just seems.
Do you know when Jen goes to the driving range with me? Father's Day, my birthday. Those are the 2 days I can get her at the driving range with me.
Like, I'm good. I think it's fun, but I'm not good.
And if anything, you want Top Golf.
I just want Top Golf.
Right, yeah.
Yeah, just give me Top Golf.
Yeah.
But a driving range, that's kind of the same.
It's a good time. So how long ago was it when you went to golf the round?
Like almost 3 weeks ago.
Oof, Rachel. Okay.
Yeah.
Did anything happen during the date to make you go like, you know what? This was a little issue, just something like that?
I've been racking my brain trying to figure it out, and no.
Well, then, Rachel, let's do this. Because I go, you like golf, he likes golf, it's a good way to start. Unless something else happened, or maybe he's just been busy with work. 3 weeks is a long time. It is summer, though. So let's play a song, and we'll call up Ben, and, we'll just try to get some answers for you, okay?
Okay. Thank you.
with your second date update. Helping out Rachel, who went to a driving range with Ben, went to golf the round, had a good time. That was 3 weeks ago, though. Doesn't feel good saying that. So, Rachel, we're going to call up Ben. Just listen in, and let's see what happens, okay?
Thank you.
Hello.
Hey, is Ben there?
This is Ben.
Ben.
Who is this?
Yeah, what up, Ben? My name is John. Chantel's here as well. The two of us, we do a morning radio show and podcast together. On the radio, we're on Mix 105.1 in Salt Lake. How are you? Good morning. I hope it's okay, but you're on the radio.
Good morning.
Morning.
Did I win something?
No, it's not a contest today, but our show does something called the Second Date Update. And what we do is we help out listeners who have gone out on a date and now they're not hearing back from the other person. And you went out with Rachel a few weeks ago now, about 3 weeks ago.
I did.
Yeah. And we're calling to see what's going on. Like, you know, why you haven't been calling her back.
Why is she on the line? Is she on the...
I mean, yeah.
Is she here?
Do you want to talk to her?
Hey. Hi. Hello?
Hello.
Hi.
Hey, Rachel, hey.
You know, we talked, and Ben, I got to say that Rachel thought you guys had a good time at the driving range. We heard you hit a bucket of balls. Like,
yeah, like having a girl also interested in golf is kind of a big win, isn't it?
I thought so. I thought so. Yeah. Like that's. I guess why we went there and. I thought so. But like, Rachel, like, have you ever been golfing like on a golf like on a course before?
Why?
Well, just like, it's just kind of weird. Like the number one rule in golf is you don't talk while somebody's swinging and. There was just a...
Yeah, that's a big room.
I don't know. It was getting a little disenchanting. Like, it was, we're golfing and just talking. Like, imagine if we would have went to, like, a movie and you just would have been talking during the movie the whole time. It's just like there's times on a date that you talk and then there's times that you don't. I don't know. Like...
I understand what you're saying.
Like, the day was fine.
But this obviously to you.
Can I be honest?
Yeah, please, Rachel.
Do you know why I was constantly talking?
While I was swinging?
At any time?
You seem like a talkative person.
No, it's because you don't talk at all.
Oh, you're feeling the silence.
And it made me nervous.
All right.
Yeah, that's feeling the silence there. So what I'm feeling is that there's a different personality between both Ben and Rachel.
Right.
That so just from conversation to maybe even golf style and everything in between, I'm feeling that there isn't a second date. Ben, are you interested? Like, we're happy to pay for something that's more dinner related, not golf related. Like,
no, I think I'm good.
Yeah.
Like.
Yeah, you're okay.
Like, I'm not trying to be mean. There wasn't a lot of chemistry. There's a lot of talking.
Right.
I think I'm good.
Is there an artist or a song that you force your partner or your children to listen to that they're not into? I'll give you an example. And then we'll take your calls. We'll take your texts. 844-649-1051. You know, sometimes I'll just let the smart speaker play its own stuff. Like, hey, play me some songs from the 90s or whatever. And whenever this song comes on, my kids know to be quiet. Because it's dad's time to reminisce.
I'm nervous.
Backbeat, the word is on the street that the fire in your heart is out. I'm sure you've read it all before, but you never really had a doubt. I don't believe that anybody... feels the way I do about you now.
Yeah. Yes.
That's right.
I mean, yeah, I know.
Obviously. You know.
I get it.
You would, if we were at lunch and this came on.
Conversation immediately needs to halt.
Yes. There's nothing more important than this song being played. It's who I am as a person, Chantel.
True. I get it.
Do you have anything like that? Like an artist or a song where you're like, this is mom's time where you're trying to teach them so bad?
Oh, I mean, like, George Strait comes on and I'm like, shh. Oh,
do you love me? Do you want to be my friend? And if you do.
Oh, yeah.
You like sit him down and explain to him the importance of George Strait.
This is how you're a gentleman. This Boone, your middle name is Troubadour after the king.
Of this person right here. You sit down, you listen to what he's saying to you.
I will say Boone loves the Troubadour song.
Oh,
his song.
Yeah.
He doesn't recognize that the rest of George Strait's songs are also
That's funny.
Important.
So what about you? What artist, what song do you force your partner or children to listen to? You're like, this is my jam. This text says, my wife hates Red Hot Chili Peppers, but I love them.
California, best
MP. Oh, yeah. It's just so good. How can you not like it?
I know.
I'm stunned.
The text says, but I love them. She hates the days when I control Alexa.
Yeah.
Yeah. You gotta have like the fight over who's in control of the playlist for the day.
Yeah. Oh, but it's just so good. Don't hate. Lean in.
Don't hate. Appreciate.
Yeah, something like that.
I love Metallica. My kids can't stand them. I always blare it in my car. Metallica. I like some good hard rock.
Yeah.
And I tried hard, like, when Liam started getting into drums.
Yeah.
I wanted him to, like,
do the Metallica thing.
Yeah, Metallica, AC/DC, you know, just something, like, where there's a really good drum beat to it.
Yeah.
He's leaning towards more, like, the Green Day Blink 182, so I can't complain because it's still, like, it's my wheelhouse
of
music.
Yep.
But I wouldn't mind a little Metallica being played down in the basement. I'm like, yeah, get it.
My parents always try to get us into like Aerosmith, Journey.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Which succeeded.
Right.
Like, it's so good.
Solid. What artists are you forcing your kids to listen to? Maybe force your partner to listen to that they can't stand. Call or text us right now.
844-649-1051.
We're just kind of finishing up the what artist or song do you force your partner or children to listen to? The sex. Oh, good. We have one who's messing with their parents. My dad doesn't understand K-pop, but my sister and I love it. Whenever we can, we play it for him. I apologize to K-pop. This is the only.
Yeah.
We don't have a lot in our system. I will tell you. You know, BTS is kind of split. Now they're all doing their own songs. The same thing like with One Direction, right? The amount of the BTS army who has now chosen a side, who send us open mics or emails requesting specific
member
songs. Now, yeah, it's getting crazy.
Wow.
I know. Like, I don't know. We just hang out.
We just play music.
My husband took me on a first date to New Kids on the Block. He hated them then. And he hates them now.
Something so changed.
You know, though, back then, he was willing to take you to the concert and
sit
through
it. Yeah, because he was trying to impress you.
Yeah, exactly. It's funny how that changes over
years.
Isn't
it, though?
Now you'd be like, hey, let's go see New Kids on the Block. And he'd be like, don't you have some girlfriends?
Yeah, don't you have something
You know what would be great?
Else?
Like, if we did a... This would be really fun and good for us. You do something on your own.
And I'll do something on my own.
It'll make us miss each other more.
Yes.
Yeah, that's healthy, right? That's fine.
Exactly.
All right, coming up next, we got to check in with our hot topic involving pink and some ashes. It's Mix 1051. At the beginning of the show, right at, before we do our hot topic to kick everything off, Chantel starts with things that are trending during the day.
Yep.
So we'd actually do it twice. I know we have one coming up, but we also do it at the beginning. And you told a story about how pink was up on stage and somebody threw a Ziploc bag to her.
Yep.
Little snacks, some cookies inside?
No.
Ashes. The person's dead mother's ashes were inside the Ziploc bag. Poor Pink didn't know what to do. We're going to play the audio. You'll hear her kind of hold it, ask to confirm, and then she's actually placing them down on the ground, and she's trying to get back into the concert. And it's so awkward. Here you go.
This is your mom? I don't know how to feel about this.
I feel so bad for her.
I feel so bad for her because she's like, oh, I don't want to get canceled.
Right. So the video.
But like, this is gross.
It's gross. The video's up on Instagram on our Insta story. You got to watch it at Mix1051 Utah. And then we just asked, like, is it tacky to do what this fan did?
Right.
100% say yes, right?
Yes. No.
No.
90% say yes. There are 10% of people saying that, oh, it's fine.
Do you think
what?
Are they just saying it to be, like, contrarian?
I think that we just need. Yeah, people just want to.
That's not fair to shock an artist like that.
No, absolutely not.
If it's an agreement, if you've said, hey, you talk to the management, they're like, oh, yeah, and Pink's going to do a thing. But just to hand someone ashes of your dead relative.
Nope.
I don't think it's cool. But if you disagree with us, go to Instagram, get your vote on at Mix1051 Utah.
Let's do it. Let's talk what's trending. Well, Kelly Clarkson is kicking off her residency in Las Vegas, and she did so with a really fun flash mob out in New York in Central Park.
Her voice is amazing.
So good. She is like, so good.
She literally is just walking up to this area of Central Park. And she just starts, I mean, listen to that, like, singing.
90% of artists that we listen to cannot sing like this.
No.
It's all production.
Yeah.
And she's pure talent.
And she has like this group just harmonizing around her.
It's amazing. Oh, it's so good. Uh-huh. Chills.
I know.
Anyway, so she went and sang her new song, Lighthouse, in Central Park.
Cool.
And then her residency is going to kick off here pretty soon out in Las Vegas, so that'll be fun.
I wonder if she's just doing it for summer because they're on the hiatus before her show starts again.
Maybe.
Or, yeah, I don't know.
I feel like I just need to go over this again because it's our hot topic for the day with the pink.
Oh, yeah, yeah,
and
please.
The ashes. So right now, if you haven't voted for our hot topic, go to our Instagram page at Mix1051Utah. A woman threw her mother's ashes on stage with Pink in a Ziploc baggie.
Yeah.
And it's just like, we're asking tacky or not. On Instagram, it's 93% say it's tacky, 7% say it's totally fine. But here's Pink's reaction to the incident.
This is your mom?
The bag next to a speaker and like rubs her hands off like ew because it is ick.
I just felt so bad for Pink because she's up there doing her concert. All of a sudden someone throws a Ziploc bag up. She picks it up. They're like, that's my mom in there.
Right.
What do you want Pink to do with that?
All I know is that 7% of people who listen to our show are disgusting.
Because they say it's not tacky at all.
Yes. It's so crazy.
I don't get that.
I know. All right, we are just a little over an hour away from the United States Air Force flyover. The United States Air Force is going to be sending crews up into the air today, including in Utah, to celebrate 100 years of aerial refueling. The Utah Air National Guard's 151st Air Refueling Wing is going to fly over the state today, starting at 9:40 a.m. They're going to go to Utah State University. Then they're going to fly over Lagoon about 9:50. Then they're going to fly over the Capitol Building about 9:56. And then from 9:56 to 10:05, they're going to be flying along I-15, passing all like Sandy, Bluffdale, Draper, all those cities. They're going to get to BYU and UVU at 10:03. And then they're going to circle back around, go through Saratoga Springs, Harriman, and then make it all the way back down to St. George.
Wow.
About 11 o'clock this morning, they're going to get St. George. And then they're going to head back up and go through Heber, Park City, and then back to the Air Force
Base. Said they're taking off at 9:45, 9:46?
9:40.
9:40? And they're going to make it to BYU at what time?
10.
It's the only way to travel.
Isn't that crazy?
Yeah.
And then all the way down to St. George by
cool.
11.
Oh, I want to get outside.
It's so cool. It's going to go on today between 9:40 and noon.
Yeah.
If you hear it, don't freak out. It's going to be loud.
It's not an invasion.
Awesome.
It's a flyover.
Yeah.
It's awesome.
Yeah, it's going to be so cool. Take Instagram videos. If you do, tag us at Mix 105 in Utah, and that's what's trending.
In fact, I saw that you put the flight path up on our Instagram Insta story as well. So, at Mix 105 in Utah there.
With a suspicion, you look for evidence. Are you paranoid or on the right track? Catching the Cheaters with Chantel's Roses.
If you feel like someone's cheating on you, I want to get to the bottom of it. I'm going to call them up, offer a dozen free roses they can send to anyone special in their life. The goal would be they go to their significant other, but sometimes they send them to someone else and we catch a cheater.
Hoping that doesn't happen today as we say good morning to Liz. Hi, Liz.
Good morning.
Morning. So tell us what's going on. What made you reach out to us?
Okay, so, I mean, I sometimes binge listen to your Roses show, so I'm not sure you guys have gotten into my head or if my intuition is right.
You know, it's kind of like we were talking about people who listen to too many, like, murder mystery podcasts, and then they start to, like, get really, like, nervous or paranoid.
Right.
Kind of the same idea. So, kind of walk us through your thought process, and we'll help you out here.
Okay, sounds good. So, my husband and I, we have another couple that we're really close friends with. And my husband, his name's Andrew, he told our friend that he's been having these, like, crazy, vivid, sexy dreams about one of his coworkers.
Okay. And do we know the coworker's name? Just because that'll help in the future in case something does happen.
Yeah. So the coworker's name is Stacy.
Okay.
And I guess Andrew told his friend, who tells his wife, who then tells me, and... I mean, of course, the first thing I do, the first thing I do is look up Stacy online.
Yes, absolutely. Instagram.
She tells me, of course you did,
Like, is there any other first thing you do?
No.
So, she's single, she's 10 years younger than me, and she's hot.
Oh,
like,
gosh.
She looks good.
You're, like, spinning now.
Yeah. Okay. I guess here's my, originally, Liz, when you started and you were saying how you have like this other friend that's couples, I thought there was something happening between the other ones, but that's just because that's how you found out. It was like a game of telephone. So Andrew told the friend who told the wife who told you about this.
So you're like, okay, is this real? Is this not real?
Right. Oh.
Exactly.
But then you're like, crap, she's hot. So it's gotta be real.
Help things.
Right. It's like, you know, it starts off as a dream, but I mean, okay, so, you know what, I don't know if he's telling our friend because he's, like, hinting that he's having an affair, or if he's just, like, I'm having these sexy dreams, and now I'm, like interested in her.
Yeah.
I don't know.
That's hard because, is he just doing that because that's, like, the PG story of what's really going on in his life, but he felt like he had to tell someone, so he's kind of changed some of the truth, and that, or is it just, you know, guy talk? And guy talk is guy talk. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah, like, you can't judge guys for guy talk, just like girls and girl talk.
Right, exactly. Everyone shares their own stuff.
Yep, and it's always exaggerated in those moments.
Right. So this is what we need to do, Liz. Let's, we'll get Andrew's number off air. We'll call him up. We'll offer the dozen roses, and we're going to see if he wants to send them to you or if Stacy is a threat that we need to be paying attention to, okay?
Okay.
And Chantel, we're catching those cheaters with Chantel's roses. Liz called us. So Liz, her husband Andrew, has been having crazy sexy dreams about a coworker named Stacy. Now, I know you're saying, how do we know this? Well, Andrew told his friend, who told his wife, who then went and told Liz. Mm-hmm. And now we're wondering, wait, is this just like some, you know, guy talk that's spun out of control, or is there more to it? We do know that Stacy is a little bit younger and she is single because Liz did some recon for us. So Liz, we're going to call up Andrew. We're going to offer the dozen roses. We're going to see who he wants to send them to. We just need permission from you to have your husband on the radio show.
Yes.
Okay. You ready, Chantel?
Yeah, let's do it.
Hello?
Hi, is this Andrew?
Yeah.
Hi, it's Chantel from J&C Flowers. How are you doing today?
Good. What is this about?
So we're a new flower shop here in Utah, and so one thing we're doing right now is giving away a dozen, like, free roses, and I was wondering if you had anyone special in your life that we could send flowers to for you today.
Oh, that's very nice.
Yeah. I know, it seems like a little weird, but I promise we're just like a new company trying to get our name out. So if you could help us by letting us send flowers, it would be amazing.
I mean, yeah, I'll take some free flowers. Why not?
Okay, cool. With the flowers, I can also include a card, and then we'll get those delivered today. Do you want me to write a message in a card for you?
Yeah. Have the message say, you're a hottie.
Okay. And then who can I address it to?
Liz.
Yeah, that's right, Liz.
Oh, perfect.
Okay, good.
Andrew.
Awesome. Andrew.
I was stressed.
Oh, hi, Andrew. My name is John. You were talking to Chantel. I got to let you know that you're on the radio on Mix 105.1. We also have the John and Chantel podcast. And your wife, Liz, is also on the phone right now. I know this is a lot coming at you, but Liz, do you want to tell Andrew why, you know, we're all on the phone?
Hi.
Are there no free flowers?
Blake told Heather that you were having dreams about a coworker.
Yeah.
This is so embarrassing.
Yeah.
Andrew, I looked her up on Instagram. She's hot. I'm feeling insecure.
Babe, you're beautiful. She's nothing. I'm so absolutely embarrassed that we have to talk about it this way. But, you know, I just had a stupid, dirty dream. And, like, that's all it was. Like, it was just dumb guy talk between Blake and I.
You don't want to be with her?
I'm married to you? Like, she's just a coworker. It was inappropriate for me to share that dream, you know. I was just being dumb with Blake and...
Yeah, guy talk. You know.
No. That's fine. I mean, yeah, guy talk. I get it. We all have dreams.
Right. Cool.
Yeah, you know, look, next time, let's just talk about it so I don't have to be admitting my dreams on the radio, okay?
Sorry, Andrew. Look, guys, I think you're both... It's just communication. Yeah, that's all it is, right, Chantel?
Yeah, I think you're great.
Liz, are we okay?
Yeah.
Let me just say one thing.
Mm-hmm.
If you talk to a friend who's married, you have to assume they're going to tell their wife.
Always.
They're going to tell their spouse.
Every time.
Your secret, they're going to tell them.
Yep.
It just is what it is.
When you're telling the one, you're telling the other.
Yes. It's that time. Time for the pickup line at 9. I'm going to challenge our pickup line friends. Send us an open mic with your favorite pickup line so we can play your delivery. Chantel says my delivery on these are absolutely terrible. So download the Mix app. Send us your best pickup line. We'll play it. Give us your name also so we can give you a shout out. Hey, girl.
Hey.
People call me John. But you can just call me tonight. Hey, speaking of tours and concerts, we've been talking all morning long about Pink, how the other night she was in London and she was performing up on stage. And what happens during a lot of concerts, you know, the artist walks around. Artists are given flowers or toys, stuffed animals. Happens a lot to Pink.
Normal things.
This time around, a plastic baggie was thrown up on stage. And inside that baggie was the person's mother's ashes.
So crazy.
And Pink was pretty confused about the whole thing and was kind of like, I don't know what to do about this.
Right.
She dropped him down.
The poll up on Instagram.
Yes.
93% are saying tacky. 7%.
I don't understand that.
7% of y'all are gross.
So you can go to Instagram. You can vote on that for our hot topic for the day, if it's tacky or not. You can also see the video of Pink holding up the ashes. It's all at Mix 105.1 Utah. But someone decided to post because of that unusual request. Other unusual funeral requests from celebrities.
Oh.
It's on BuzzFeed this morning. You know Tupac? His ashes were smoked by members of his group, Outlaws.
Interesting.
I had no clue, but how did I miss that? There's a famous author named Hunter S. Thompson. He wrote Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas and other books. Well, Johnny Depp actually played him in the movie. He honored his request to have his ashes fired from a cannon.
Wow.
The inventor of Pringles?
Uh-huh.
He had his ashes buried in a Pringles can. Original flavor.
I love that.
That's like fantastic. The best. Isn't that great?
That's
I know.
Fantastic.
Carrie Fisher, her ashes are up in an urn that's shaped like a Prozac pill. which I thought was funny.
Random.
Here's another one I had no clue about. Bruce Lee. Footage from his actual funeral was used in his last film, Game of Death. There's a scene where you can see his face in his casket.
Oh.
Now, was that a request or was that through the family and talking to the director? Like, I want to know.
Yeah.
The Luke Perry one was a pretty big deal because he was buried in that mushroom burial suit to become a tree.
Oh, right.
Remember that? That was kind of a big one. The inventor of Doritos was buried in a box surrounded by Doritos chips. Again, these inventors have it right. Like,
yeah,
they're doing it the right way.
Yeah, I mean, they get it. They're like, I made chips.
James Doohan, who was Scotty in Star Trek, one of the astronauts smuggled his ashes into the International Space Station.
Oh, my gosh.
But it's Star Trek, of course. It should be. What other ones? Aretha Franklin. She had 4 outfit changes for her 3 viewings in her funeral.
Okay, that's a lot of work for the...
I know. The staff.
Staff.
Right. That's diva till the end.
For real.
Author Roald Dahl had a Viking-inspired funeral.
Oh, so he did the push me out to sea?
Yeah. And he was buried, or when he was being pushed out, also on there were his pencils that he wrote all of his books with, and chocolates.
Aww.
From Willy Wonka,
and
yeah.
They put it on fire, right?
Yeah, 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 and then it burned. And then finally, much like Aretha Franklin, Elizabeth Taylor, she wanted to be fashionably late to her service, so it began 15 minutes after its announced start time.
Oh my gosh.
Which I think is funny. All right, what do you have? Oh, so first of all, again, go to our Instagram, go to our Insta story, vote if it's tacky or not to throw ashes up on a stage when an artist is performing.
Imagine when you're walking into TJ Maxx or Target. Mm-hmm. What's the first sensation you get? Excitement?
I'm overwhelmed.
Debt? loss of money?
I used to hate the lighting in those places.
Some people, it's like the smell, yeah. The excitement. Other people, it's the strong sense of strong urge to go use the restroom. And TikTok is going viral where a woman walks into TJ Maxx and suddenly needs to go, well, you know, number 2. And apparently this is like super popular and a lot of people can relate to this. Like thousands of comments are calling it the laxative effect.
This is a thing?
Of stores like this. And some employees say even they're aware of it.
Wait, there's a thing where you walk into stores and you have to go doo-doo?
I can confirm this because growing up,
We
could not go to Hobby Lobby because it would make my mom have to go to the restroom.
What?
It's the craziest thing. And it's there's a lot of stores. So people say it includes Ross, Barnes & Noble, Macy's, Home Goods, Michael's, amongst others. And what we in my family had chalked it up to be or whatever,
yeah,
is like that smell of the fake flowers.
Like potpourri?
No, like the eucalyptus-y smell, like of, not maybe not eucalyptus, but it's like the smell of like the fake flower section.
Uh-huh. That
it like makes you have to go to the bathroom.
Why have I never noticed this before?
No, I'm telling you, like, this is a thing. Because my sister has the same problem, too. I think I don't have this problem.
Is it a specific, I mean, you said your mom with Hobby Lobby, so is it a specific store?
It's a specific store
for certain people.
Certain people. Isn't that crazy?
Okay, you know what we need to do? Today's Hot Topic's already been taken because we're talking the whole pink thing. Tomorrow, let's ask if people have to go number 2 when they walk into
the store. Is there a certain store you go in that you're like, oh my gosh, I'm going to have to go to the bathroom?
Yeah.
Like as soon as I get in there, I'm going to have to go to the bathroom.
Like is it Target?
I won't be able to make it home.
Okay. We'll put that on our show plan for tomorrow.
Okay.
And if you have any comments on it, you can already go to our Instagram, drop us a DM. We'll read them tomorrow as we kick off the Hot Topic.
Yep.
At Mix 105.1 Utah. That is the strangest thing. I've never heard that before.
I mean, it's going viral.
You know, earlier this morning, we were talking about, like, when was the last time you cried?
Uh-huh.
We had so many texts I didn't get to. This text says, last time I cried was an emotional breakdown I had about 2 weeks ago. The ugly kind of crying with sobbing and snot bubbles.
No!
I'm a 35-year-old man, and I'm finally learning to regulate and deal with my emotions. You've been pushing them down and repressing them.
Right.
Comes up like that.
Yep.
Like a volcano.
Seriously.
Ooh, good old-fashioned snot bubble cry.
Man, those feel good, though, after.
Jamie texted us. Hi, Jamie. I cried last night at the gym while I was working out. I think all the stress was leaving my body.
I need that. I can feel it. I just can't get it out.
You feel, like, bottled?
Yeah.
You need to go home. You need to watch P.S. I Love You.
Ooh.
You ever see P.S. I Love
yes.
You?
Yes. No, I think I need to watch Marley and Me.
Oh,
that'll, no. That'll get you going.
Don't ever torture
anything
yourself
anything about
like
a
that.
Dog.
Oh, my gosh, no.
Let's leave you with a fun fact.
Led Zeppelin, R.E.M., and Depeche Mode, all three of those bands, famous bands, right?
Mm-hmm.
Have never had a number one single.
Wow. That's crazy.
The article brought up how Rihanna has had 14. Like, yeah, because she does bangers. But so has Led Zeppelin, R.E.M., and Depeche Mode.
Yeah.
Imagine being that famous.
And not a number one.
I know. Chantel, have a good day.
Hey, you too.